Like anybody that makes cocktails, you know about straining. But you know about double straining. Welcome to the Cocktail Spirit from Small Screen Network. I'm your host, Robert Hess. We're doing a set of episodes on ways to improve the cocktails you make, whether at your professional bar or at home for friends. Now, one of the things that people do when making cocktails is they obviously strain the drink into the glass. That's keeping the ice back into the shakers. For straining, you're going to use something like this, a hawthorn strainer, or perhaps this, a julep strainer. The intent of these is, like I said, to hold the ice back so you're not spending ice into the cocktail glass, because a glass like this, you want it served straight up without any ice in it. There are times, however, where you might want to do double straining. And for double straining, using something like this, a fine mesh strainer. This would be cases where maybe the pulp that's in the lemon juice, you're not wanting to go into the glass. In many cases, it's not that big a deal, depending upon the casuality of the cocktails you're doing, but the finer and finer you want to take and serve cocktails, and if I'm going to serve a cocktail in a fine glass like this, I really am wanting to take and make that drink as fine as possible. I'm going to take and perhaps strain any of the juices so that all the pulp from the lemons, the limes, the oranges, or the grapefruit are going to stay in the strainer. Another thing to strain back is I'm going to add some mint to the drink. I want to take and strain back any of the mint leaves that might possibly float in there so you don't get them stuck on your teeth and stuff like that. So we're going to show you here a drink, a very fine, very classic style cocktail that uses both mint as well as juices. So we're going to take and show double straining in that fashion. This is a drink created by Audrey Saunders for the Pegu Club called the Old Cuban. It starts out with an ounce of simple syrup. I'm using a 1-to-1 simple syrup, so one part water to one part sugar. Shake it up, let it settle, shake it again until it's all nicely dissolved. In this case, I'm using an organic raw sugar, and that's why it's slightly in the brown color. We add 1 ounce of that. Now we're going to add 3/4 ounce of lime juice. Now I mentioned that you might want to double strain the lime, the drink when it goes into the glass, or you're holding back the pulp from the lime before it goes in. In this particular case, I squeeze the limes and then I use my fine mesh strainer before going into the craft, so this has already been strained. Now, since this drink is using muddled mint, I'm going to stop adding ingredients at this point in time, add the mint to muddle it. So we're adding about 6 or 7 leaves of mint, depending upon the size of the leaves, and I'm going to muddle it. Now, another point that we're going to cover in a different episode is about how to muddle properly, but you notice I'm not going to town on this mint. I'm basically just trying to espresso the oils. Now we're going to add our base spirit. In this case, we're using Bacardi 8 rum. This is actually a product that Audrey specced for this drink, and this is the product she likes using for it. You can use another rum if you want, but this is the way the drink actually should taste. We're going to add 1.5 ounces. And then a dash of Bitter Truth aromatic bitters. And shake with ice. And then here's where the double straining comes in. I put the regular hawthorn strainer on the top of the tin. I hold the fine mesh strainer over the glass. And then I just pour in. I'm going to take and move around so if any of the mint leaves or ice shards might get caught up in the mesh, it's not going to take and stop the flow of the cocktail as it's going in. Now, since I didn't party on the mint too hard, I'm not getting an awful lot, but you can see there are some little shards of mint that are in my strainer that hold back, and so they didn't get it into the cocktail itself. But the flavor of the mint still made its way through. Now we're going to top this off with champagne. You always want to be careful when you're opening champagne. Once the cage is released, you basically got a loaded bullet sitting here. And so you always want to take and make sure you try to keep your thumb over top of it, pointed away as you twist the bottle and keep the cork from flying away. Now we're going to add about 2 ounces of champagne. And there we have the old Cuban, a very classy drink served elegantly through the technique of double straining.